ESA astronaut Thomas Pesquet from France is now in the second month of his long-duration stay on board the ISS. He'll soon be venturing outside the station to carry out scheduled maintenance operations, becoming the 11th European to take part in an extra-vehicular activity, or EVA. Floating in the vastness of space is a long-held dream for every astronaut, but it's a risky and highly complex procedure. In the months leading up to launch, Thomas was put through an exhaustive program of EVA training at NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Together with veteran crewmate Peggy Whitson, he spent many hours in the classroom, becoming familiar with all the procedures he could be called upon to carry out in orbit. In conjunction, he was given extensive hands-on experience of the station's array of specialized tools and hardware. Thomas also had to learn how to work inside an EVA suit, which provides astronauts with life support, mobility and communications whilst working outside the station.
I remember the first time getting into the suit. You're crammed in the suit and it's very rigid, so it doesn't feel like you're wearing the suit. It feels like you're locked into something very rigid, like a coffin, but with a window that you can look through. That's really the first feeling I had when I started my training.
At Johnson Space Center, the space environment is simulated using a large pool known as the Neutral Buoyancy Lab. Here, astronauts can train on replica ISS modules, gradually learning how to operate the EVA suit to carry out complex tasks in microgravity. It's very hard work, but a vital part of every astronaut's pre-flight training.
EVA training is fantastic. It's physically difficult. It's one of the most challenging parts of the training, but it's also one of the most realistic. When you're in the pool for 6 hours, you get tired, but at some point you really think you're on the ISS. You look around you, and there's a structure everywhere. Sometimes you even get disoriented, because that's what happens in space. It's like a 3D labyrinth of technology. It's a maze of technology.
In orbit, Thomas will soon be carrying out these operations for real. He'll be spending up to 7 hours alongside Station Commander Shane Kimbra during the second of two planned spacewalks to upgrade the station's batteries. These work in conjunction with the station's solar arrays and store power for use as it flies through the Earth's shadow. ESA astronaut Luca Parmitano, who spent 6 months on board the ISS in 2013, will be guiding procedures as lead communicator from NASA's Mission Control in Houston. As a veteran of two EVAs, his involvement pays tribute to ESA's expertise in manned spaceflight operations and will provide a reassuring presence during the first spacewalk of Thomas Pesquet's astronaut career.